Good day, viewers at home. We want to welcome you again to another time of study in God's presence. We trust that the Lord will bless and enrich our lives as we study together. We are still continuing in our introductory series, and our topic for today says, we are created for His purpose. With me in the studio to discuss this are Venerable Obioma Onwuzurumba, a priest, a retired priest in the diocese, and Dame Chine Lodan Nzelu, a member of the Bible study team in St. James Church, Asokoro. Remember, our topic says we are created for His purpose. Before we read the background text, I would like to take our aims. We have two aims. One is to realize the whole essence of our creation / existence, and also to realize the need to seek to please God earnestly. Variables, I would like to start with you. Please, can you read for us the background text, Genesis chapter 1, 26 to 28, sir?
Genesis chapter 1, verses 26 through to 28, and I read, "And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth." So God created man in His own image. In the image of God created He him. Male and female created He them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, "Be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth."
Thank you, sir. May God bless the reading of His word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Dame, you'd also take us through Exodus chapter 8, verse 1, and Psalm 8, 3 to 8, quickly.
Exodus 8, verse 1. "And the Lord spake unto Moses, Go unto Pharaoh, and so say unto him, Thus saith the Lord, let my people go, that they may serve me." And then Psalm chapter 8 from 3. Psalm 8, 3 to 8. "When I consider the heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the star, which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet, on all sheep and oxen, yea, and the beasts of the field, the fowl of the air, and the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passeth through the parts of the seas." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let me quickly take Revelation 4:11 as we continue. Revelation chapter 4, verse 11. "You are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power. For you created all things, and by your will they exist, and we are created." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let me take the introduction from the outline. Christians should ask themselves, why was I created? Many don't seem to know the reason or reasons for their existence, and so they live as they please, or as situation or men dictate. God created man in His image with specific purpose in mind that we can see very well from Genesis chapter 1, 27 to 28, where our Venerable read, and then chapter 2, verse 15, and as well as Psalm 8, 4 to 8, and Revelation 4, 11. God acts with purpose, and He usually makes His purposes known to those concerned. He made known His purpose for the Israelites' freedom from the Egyptian bondage in Exodus chapter 8, verse 1. Made known what Samson would do, as well as the purpose for sending His only son into the world. Despite this, mankind still ignore or abuse the purpose of God for their lives. As we move on in the discussion, we want to look at what is the purpose behind our living and our existence. And I trust that God will help us by the end of this study to realize that and live to fulfill it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Venerable sir, let's begin with you in our study guide. From our text, what do you think are God's purposes in creating man? And then the B part of that question says, why and how may we achieve these purposes? Looking at those background scriptures there.
Yeah, moderator. Looking at the text, we will quickly discover that one thing runs through our text, that everything is of God. God started everything.
Yes, sir.
He created us and he created everything. And in the Genesis text we read, we can see there that God made man and put him to rule over his creation.
Mm.
And also we find that in Revelations we're told that the purpose for his creation is that everything he created should give him the glory through worshiping him and doing what pleases him. So if I may put it in a very, sum it up, that God actually created us so we can bring pleasure to him.
Yes, sir.
So we can make him really happy. Mm. So we can exalt him because he's God.
Yes, sir.
He's the one that created us.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. And then the B part of it says, why and how may we achieve this purpose?
Yes. We know that when you want to enjoy the best part of anything that is made, you've got to make reference to the Maker.
Yes, sir.
And it's only by knowing his instructional manual for operating that particular thing will you enjoy it and be able to do what is expected. So God, everything starts with God. So we must go back to him and thank God for the word of God that is there to lead us and tell us what the Creator, the one who made us and made us for himself, requires of us. So that, to me, essentially, is what we need to do to be able to, you know, fulfill the purpose of God for making us.
Thank you, sir. That was quite incisive. Dame, can we look at question two? How are the purposes of God for mankind being abused in our contemporary world? There are some reference scriptures there.
Yes. To enable us properly discuss this, I would like to make a reference to Deuteronomy chapter 8. Let's take just 11 to 14. He said, beware that thou forget not the Lord thy God in not keeping his commandments and his judgments and his statutes, which I command you this day. It's like a command, and it is a command. Lest when thou hast eaten and you are full, and hast built godly houses and dwell therein, and when thy herds and thy flocks multiply, and thy silver and thy gold is multiplied, and all that thou hast is multiplied, then thy heart be lifted up, and I forget the Lord thy God, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. So this is very critical, because it's asking, how can you disobey? That is, how do you miss God's original purpose and blessing for our life? And when we look at what happened during time, the Exodus that we were referred to, 32:1-4, we're not going to read it, but we all know the building of the calf, the golden calf and everything, the children of Israel. You know, we need to see the disobedience of God's children that he has brought out of Egypt. You know, the miracles he meted upon these his loved ones, and yet they disobeyed. They became impatient. And God has blessed them with gold and silver, and they use it to have an out of impatience, and they don't know their Lord, their God. They don't know the Lord their God that brought them out. They could not even, they didn't even appreciate what God has done. What did they do? They molded golden this thing, calves, and started worshiping idolatry. This is one of the areas that you say how the purpose of God for mankind have been, we abuse the purpose of God. We most of us go to church. Yes, come to church the way you are, but don't go back from church the way you came. So they were there. God meted so much, loved them, the children of Israel, like he's loving us today. But even as Christians, we find ourselves where we are not supposed to be.
Yes, ma'am.
We put things before God, worshiping idol. Idolatry is one of them. And when we read Deuteronomy, which I've read, he said pride and arrogance. God's original purpose for us is to bless us. When he kept our first parents, Adam and Eve, in the garden to enjoy, he comes down, as our daddy said, to fellowship with them and have pleasure. You know, he's originally to bless us and to establish us. But it's not when he has blessed you, like Nebuchadnezzar, don't forget the Lord your God. And most of us in the body of Christ forget the Lord our God when he has blessed us. So it's original that he will bless us, that we possess the gates of our enemies. But does it mean that you should forget the Lord your God? That you should not want to be worshipped? Start worshipping the Creator. The Creator instead of the Creator. You know, so all these things, pride, arrogance, and not knowing the Lord our God. You know, the word of God is new every morning. You must study this word of God. Appropriate it. You must be diligent in following Christ. You know, I think Romans that we still go through. When you reflect upon it, you know, you have to be diligent. When you're not diligent, I tell people that following Christ is a veto. You know, when you believe and you follow the word of God. The word of God says so. But when you think you're following Christ today, I'm on Christ today, you say, if you are lukewarm, I will do what? I will spit you out. So these are some of the things that causes us, because we don't know him, we don't study the word, we don't come for fellowship, we don't go to church, we don't reflect him anywhere we go.
Thank you, ma. That was quite exhaustive and incisive. One of the drawouts from that contribution is disobedience.
Yes.
And sometimes even God's blessings upon our life can make us forget him, like the children of Israel. He blessed them. But what did they do with that blessing? They turned out and molded calf images and worship. I pray that the blessings of God on our life will not make us miss our purpose. Mm-mm. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Venerable sir, in discussing question 3, discuss practically the factors and forces that militate against our fulfilling God's purpose and what we must do to prevail against them. There are some reference scriptures there. Can you briefly?
Yes. In discussing in very practical terms the forces that militate against our fulfilling God's purpose, we need to remember again that how we began to disobey God was by questioning God's instructions. When Adam and Eve were in the garden and they were told exactly what to do and what not to do, the devil came with his deceit.
Yes, sir.
And said, did God really say? So that's the beginning of our enemy with regards to fulfilling God's purpose. He wants us to misinterpret God's word, to question God's word. Like today, you can see that many people in the Western world want to rewrite the Bible, especially with regards to the issue of marriage. And when God made them male and female and decided that it should be heterosexual, they are now talking about homosexual and talking about, you know, your sexual orientation, trying to change God's order, God's specific instruction. So the devil is one of our very practical enemies. He works on our minds, changes God's instructions, even when we read the word of God and we know the truth, but we want to deny it because we want to satisfy our own selfish desires. And that is one of the sources of, you know, of factors and forces. Then self, because people, you know, want to look at themselves, not at their maker. The reference point should be God and what does he want. But what the world today thinks of is, what do I want? What will make me happy? That I will do. You know, the Bible says in John, which is there, John 10:10a, that the devil has come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. That is his ministry. But God's ministry for us is to give us life
and
in abundance.
Yes,
so we know, and we have seen that other contributors have said that God's purpose for giving us his word is for our good and our happiness. But the devil doesn't want us to enjoy that happiness. So he fights very fiercely. And of course, some have been blinded to the word of God, ignorance of the word of God. You see, when we talk about the fact that Peter talks about the fact that some have become blind, short-sighted to the things God promised, to the benefits that they can get from God's, you know, being in their lives, and they have missed it all. So that's one other way. When we are not actually exploring all the beautiful things that God has given to us in his promises, we soon lose sight and begin to do other things. Of course, in James, we can see there that he also mentions the same thing, that we soon forget sometimes, forgetfulness of what God expects of us. He says, you look at yourself in the mirror, you know, you use that illustration, and you forget who you are. So we should not be forgetful hearers. We should keep the word of God always in our hearts. That's why the Bible says, David says, your word have I kept in my heart, that I might not sin against you.
Thank you, Venerable. That was quite incisive. Remember, our topic is still, we are created for God's purpose. And I think from our contribution, it's come out richly that everything we do should be to please him. We want to thank you so far for being there, listening to us, and I'm trusting God that you are being blessed. We come back in a short while to continue. God bless you.
Staying with your wife in understanding, according to the scripture, exactly. Not in beating her.
Again to this Bible study discussion. Remember, our topic still says we are created for God's purpose. I'm not alone in the studio as usual. I have our daddy, Venerable Obioma Muzurumba, a retired priest in our diocese, Abuja, and Dame Chine Loda Nunzelu, a committed Bible study teacher, St. James Church, Asokoro. Dame, we want to start with you in looking at question four. What are the consequences of living outside the purpose of God for mankind? Looking at that reference scripture, Deuteronomy chapter 8, 19 to 20.
Let me just read out Deuteronomy 8, 19 to 20 first. And it shall be, if thou do all, forget the Lord thy God, and walk after other gods, and serve them, and worship them, I testify against you this day, that you shall surely perish. Verse 20 said, as the nations which the Lord destroyeth before your face, so shall you perish, because you will not be obedient unto the voice of the Lord your God. The consequences, I will say, are directly opposite what Daddy has even highlighted. Because if you are living the way God wants you to live, in the purpose, you have peace, you have joy, you know, and it's only his blessing that will give you that peace that surpasses understanding and the unspeakable joy of a child of God. So at times, like we're told in Revelation, that you are dead and you say a child that is dead and say you are living. Many people, yes, they are breathing in and out, but they are not living, they're already dead. These are some of the consequences, and you are still here on earth. Because why, you're not achieving God's purpose for your life. If you have ever the opportunity to study this purpose-driven life by
requiring,
you will appreciate this topic of today. Because if you don't have a purpose-driven life, the consequence is that you are already dead. That is, you have chosen a path of death, and no matter if you have the whole world, we should understand and remember people like, I think, Alexander the Great, after he has conquered everything, but not, you don't have Christ. It's not the purpose of God that God has created us. Yes, he created all of us for his pleasure, and he's given all of us different gifts. He gave gifts unto us to be able to achieve this pleasure, and then you are outside it. You're on your own.
Yes, ma'am.
Not only eternal death, physical death, you are living, but you are dead. Physically, spiritually, you are dead. At the end of the day, you will still die physically, and then you will live it in eternal damnation.
Thank you, ma. That was quite.
Thank you.
If I may just add to what Dame has said, you know, many people equate success to fulfillment. But we know in practical terms that there are a lot of people today who have all the material things of this life, but they are still empty. Their life is future because they have not yet known the meaning of life. Now, our Bible tells us that life can only start to have meaning when we are in Christ. And it's only in Christ you can get to know the purpose of God for your life.
For your life, yes.
So I want to actually ask that people should first of all get to know who Christ is. Because it is in Christ we are recreated to be able to fulfill the purposes of God. Then we can have the fulfillment, the joy, the satisfaction. And we can say like Paul, I have run the race. So, or like the Bible says in Acts 13:36 that David fulfilled the purpose of God. In his generation,
yes.
And slept
with the Father.
So you find that when we have lived this life doing the purpose of God, there is joy while we are living, and even joy at our deathbed. So it is important, viewers, that we really get to know who Christ is. Because life, he says, I am the way,
the truth,
and the life. So to know the meaning and purpose of life, we must know Christ first. Thank you, sir.
You know, as we are making these contributions quite incisive, I remember the statement by St. Augustine of Hippo. You see, our life, we are created for God to inhabit. And our lives are restless until they find their rest in God. So we cannot get this fulfillment outside of Him. One of the books by Miles Munro, he talked about some critical questions that we must all address before we go. And one of it is the question of why am I created, purpose. He talked about what am I here to do, my assignment, origin, where am I from, and then eternity, where am I going. So this issue of purpose is good. Like Daddy said, you can have all the material wealth in the world, but if you're living outside of God, you may have been missing purpose. I trust that the Lord has blessed us, viewers. And I pray that we will rise up to live in purpose, even as we start the year 2018, that this will be a more purposeful year, living to fulfill God's mandate for our life. We want to thank you for joining us, and we trust that we see you again next week. Remember, this program is coming to you via the Anglican Cable Network, Nigeria. We want to thank our resource persons, Venerable Obioma Muzrumba. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir,
for coming. And then Dame Chinelo
Nzelu.
We also will not fail to take the conclusion before we take our food for thought. I read the conclusion. Beside the general purpose of God in creating mankind, there are more specific purposes for individuals, especially those regenerated by faith in Christ. The primary purpose of God in creating us is to worship Him and then rule over all other creatures. When we fail in this, we are likely to incur His wrath or expose ourselves to the wiles of the devil. Our food for thought says, when we fulfill God's purpose is when we receive God's blessing. There's a popular song, Thou Art Worthy. That's a memory verse for today. But we want to say that song together in order to remind ourselves that we are indeed created for God. Can we all say the song together?
O Lord, to receive glory, honor, and power. For Thou hast created all things, and for Thy pleasure they are and were created.
That's taken from Revelation chapter 4, verse 11. Once again, we want to thank you for being part of this study session. We trust God you will tune in again, same time, same station next week to study at the feet of Jesus. We also will want to thank again, we can't thank them enough, our resource persons who will be here. Remember, like I said, this program is coming to you from the Anglican Cable Network. If you want to be part of what God is doing in our communion by supporting this program, we would like to invite you to look at the number that are scrolling on your screen right now. You can also visit us on our social media platform, and then we trust that the Lord will bless you. See you again, same time next week. God bless you.